4 days ago, Microsoft has launched regex function in Excel, and you will see here we have three function introduced in Excel, and these are regex, means regular expressions. You generally use these functions in your Python or JavaScripts, but we will cover this function in Excel now. So here I'm going to use our regex function, and we will try to understand how these new three functions are going to work. So here, before understanding these functions, we need to learn the regex and some kind of programming language, then we can use these functions. So if I'm going to talk about this simple example, here you will see here we have three functions: regex extract, regex replace, and regex text. So regex extract is going to extract something, regex replace is going to work like a substitute function, and regex text is give you simply, if I'm putting my cursor here, it is going to show you answer in true and falses only. Now here, let's say I'm checking, I'm using extract, regex extract, and it is going to just do the extraction like left, right, mid function. Now you will see here it is asking me text. So here is my text. Now it is asking me pattern. Now this is difficult point. This we need to learn regex here. Now pattern means regex language, and you will see we need to learn various operators to deal with the regex. Now first operator in the list is dot. Dot means single element. For example, I want to check whether anything is containing between A and B. So A and B, dot is showing means anything. It can be T, A, B, whatever, it can be numeric. So if there would be any number alphabet between A and B, it is going to extract that one. So just put that thing in your double quotes and close the parentheses and enter, and you will see regex is automatically extracting this, whether it is fulfilling our need. Yes, I'm not using Office 365, so means I'm not using single cell formula. You can select multiple cell in one shot. Here I am using C. Regex is working fine. A and B, and A space P, it is also finding. Here you will see A B, there is no word or number containing between this A and B, and so on. So this is the dot, and let's try to cover the second example of regex, that is regex. Again I'm going to use regex text extract. So here is my text. Now it is going to check, I'm going to use the caret. Now caret is basically checking the starting point. So if anything is starting from any word, let's say you want to check hello, A, B, C, whatever. So let's say I'm checking in, you need to put that thing in double quotes only. So here I'm checking, let's say A. So whatever is starting with A or it is going to extract that thing. So since I have only, problem is it is going to extract the single word only. And here it is, here it is. Now we can use this example in a different kind of manner. If I'm talking about this one, here is the example. Let's say I'm using this one, and here I'm using the same example, regex extract, and here I'm selecting text, and now this time I'm using pattern. Let's say if anything is going to start with the number one or number two, so then it is going to extract that thing also. You will see here it is going to show me error. And if I'm going to extract something, it is again showing me NA. If my number is starting with 1, let's say I'm putting 1 here, and it is going to extract that 1. So you can check that thing. You can use find and search, and this is the regex caret. Now here we have one third thing in regex, that is dollar sign. Similarly, caret, it is going to search at the end. So if anything at the would be at the end, then it is going to extract that thing. So here I'm going to use regex extract, and here we have text comma pattern. I'm using, let's say, B, and we need to put the dollar sign at the end. And here we am closing my double quotes and closing my parentheses. Now you will see it is extracting the B, and we need to simply drag and drop, and you will see here we don't have any B at the end, and here we have B at the end. So it can check anything. Now here we have asterisk. This operator, what it does, it is going to extract if B, let's say I want to check A, B, C. If B would not be there, then it is still going to extract that thing. So here I'm going to use regex struct, or here we have text. Now what we need to use here, a b c, and we have not used this asterisk. If I'm going to put this asterisk on b, it means now if b would not be there, then still I'm okay. It is going to extract that thing a and c. So simply close the parentheses and you will see it has extracted that a and c. If b is there or multiple b would be there, then it is going to extract that thing also, and you will see a b c, a b b c, a b b b c, and here you will see it is working with this one also, because a and c, there is no b between a and c, so you are checking a and c, that's why it is extracting that a and c. So this is the regex function, how these functions are working here. I'm simply showing you how regex programming is working. And here we have plus sign. So again, you have multiple repetition. Let's say if b is not there, then it is not going to extract that thing. So here I'm going to use regex extract, comma, text is here, comma, and we need to use a b plus c. So if b would not be there, then it is not going to extract that thing. B should be there, or multiple b can be allowed. We need to you put that thing in double quotes, and you will see here we don't have any b, and we can simply drag and drop, and you will see it is working, it is not working. The problem is case sensitive. I have used upper a in it, so if I need to use smaller a, and I can drag and drop now, and you will see now it is working. Regex is case sensitive language, so whenever you are working with regex, so you need to use case sensitive. And here I'm coming the instance number 6, and let's say I want to check 0 or 1. I don't want to take the multiple, so I can use question mark. Question mark means one character, means either b would not be there, either b would be there, only the one character. Now I'm talking about regex extract. Here is the text, and I'm using double quotes, and here we need to use pattern. Let's say a b question mark and c. So it is going to extract either b is there or not there. We don't need multiple characters, so close the parentheses and enter, and this is the basic one. Close the and just drag and drop, and you will see it is extracting this, it is extracting this. So this is not working with these four. Now let's come to our next operator, that is n. Now what n does, let's say if I want to check 4, here I'm talking about the first instance. 4, 27 is the first three numbers in it. Now I want to check whether the 4 is there after this 4. If the answer is yes, then it is going to extract that thing. If the answer is no, then it is not going to work on that thing. So here I'm going to use regex extract, text is this one, and I'm going to use, now this time I'm going to use this n. So what I will do, I will simply use this in double quotes, and here I'm using 4, and let's say I'm using 1. So it is going to show me 1, and you will see here we have 1, 4, it is working. If I'm going to talk about 2, so it is going to check 44. If 44 is there, then it is going to work on it, and you will see and n is here because 44 is not here. And if we are using let's say 44, so now you can see it is working with that. So you can 2 means repetitions, how many times you want to repeat that number. So 44, I can write 4 and 4. This 2 is basically extending this 4. So 44. Now I'm going to cover this n and m. N means minimum number and m means maximum number. Now let's say I want to check 4. Here you will see here we have 4, 4, 4, 4, and here we have 44. So it means any 4 which are repeating, we are going to extract that thing. So that can be happen with these two operators. So here I'm going to use regex extract, and text is here. Now I'm going to use that same thing, 4. So what I want minimum at least 2, 4 should be there, and maximum 3 should be there. So it is going to, in this case, the first one, it is not going to extract a whole 4 numbers. So it is going to give me only the 3 4s. Simply we need to put the curly brackets here and close the parentheses and enter. Now you will see here it is. Now close and drag and drop, and you will see that's how it is working. 444, it is extracting because we have entered 3, maximum number is 3, and here I am entering minimum number, so that's why it is extracting the 2 also. Now let's say I want to check any number, so anything would be there. Let's say I want to extract 4, or 4 is anywhere, so I can use this square bracket. So I am going to use regex struct, here it is, and here I'm going to check 4 is anywhere. So it is going to extract that 4 from anywhere. So it is as same as your find and search, and you will see here we have 4, so that's why it is working on it. And in the second one we don't have 4, it is not working in it. Here we have 4, it is working on it, and vice and so on. So that's how it is working. Here we have open bracket and close bracket. Now let's come to our typical examples here. So if I'm simply extending my regex language, so here we have a square bracket. If I'm talking about A, B and C in a square bracket, it means I'm searching only A, B and C, means it is going to match A, B and C. We can use multiple character at once. If I'm going to talk about A to Z, so it is going to check whole alphabets, 26 alphabets it's going to check. Whenever I'm talking about this one, it means we need to check everything, but these three are not allowed. So that's how it is working. And D means any digit, it can be digit means a number 0 to 9. So we can write like this also, 0 to 9, or we can simply write slash or D. Here I'm talking about big D, match to any digit, any known digit, so means alphabets. Or here we have small w. Small w means A to Z, A to Z, and 0 to 9. And underscore is also included in this small w. And the others character are included in big w. And here we have a small s, small n mean in regex. It is a white space character which we can't see from your eyes. Let's say here we have space, tab, and new lines. And bigger S means known white space character. So I'm going to use the same technique of the regex, and I'm going to extract this thing. So here I'm going to use I'm going to extract the email IDs from this list. So here I'm going to build this regex. I'm going to use extract. So text is here, comma. Now I need to check the email IDs. So email ID is this one. So see, here we have text, so any text can be there. So here I'm checking, let's say D. So any digit or non-digit can be there, so I'm checking D. So if I'm simply checking D, so it is going to show me the first one, number one. It is showing me number one, but whatever, I want to extract the email IDs. So I need to simply extract this. I need to simply put plus sign will extract the multiple characters. And it is going to extract the matching this thing, not D, because D is only working with the numbers. So now I need to put that, I need to check this one, at the rate. So I am simply putting at the rate here, at the rate. And you will see now this time it is working like this. So now I need to extract this email.com also, so I can simply extract this thing with the same concept. I'm using W plus. So W plus is again going to extract the multiple character. So W means here we have, I'm going to check these characters, enter. So that's how it is working. Now I need to extract this dot. I need to extract this dot. So I can simply use dot, but a dot is a different operator in your regex, so we need to use slash. So what slash does, slash convert that thing into a text. So here dot has converted into a slash. So enter, and you will see we have extracted the dot, and the same thing with the dot com. So I'm going to use a slash W plus. So it is going to work with the alphabets, numeric, and the underscore. Here I'm going to use plus sign means multiple character for com. So enter. Here we have extracted the email ID. Simply we can drag and drop. and you will see we have a work on it. Now if I'm going to copy it and I'm going to cover the second one, let's say I'm using the second one, regex.replace. So text is this one, and comma, pattern is the same thing, comma, I want what I want, let's say star. And see, you can do the same thing using Flash Fill, but you can't replace the thing with the stars, but we need to use something else for that. So regex replace is comfortable for that. And you will see now email ID has gone from the text, and you will see in email ID is not working, not here also, and it is showing only star. So that's how regex replace is working. So now I'm going to extract the numbers from here. So here you will see I'm going to use regex replace once again, sorry, regex extract, and here we have text, comma, pattern I'm going to use in the same thing, same manner. I'm using slash, and I'm checking this bracket sign and closing this argument, and you will see it is extracting the bracket. Now here we have numbers, so I'm going to check the numbers by using our this d symbol, small d to digit. So underscore d, and d is going to extract only the one character. I need to put the plus sign for the multiple character. So that's how it is extracting this one. Now I need to extract this closing bracket. So I am simply putting the closing bracket after the slash to convert this into a text, and that's how it is working. Here we have space, so I can put space. Space is not a special character, and here I need to use that. I need to extract the numbers once again. So here I am going to use slash d plus, here it is. Now I'm going to use this minus sign. So I'm using again slash minus. So that's how it is working. And again, I need to use the numbers. So again, I am going to use slash d plus. Slash d is for numbers and plus is for multiple characters, and enter. So you can see I have extracted the numbers, and simply drag and drop. You will see I have extracted all the numbers from the list. So that's how your regex extract is going to work. So these are the three functions in Excel. And if I'm going to use the last one, that is regex text, so it is going to check the same thing. So let's say I'm checking this one, whether we have numbers or not. So it is going to check that thing. Regex text, text is this one, comma, pattern is this one. We need to replace this, we need to take only the patterns over here and enter, and you will see it is giving me true because the pattern is here. We can simply drag and drop, and here it is. If I'm simply changing anything, let's say A, B, C, and you will see it is giving me NA and it is giving me false. So that's how your three new function is going to work. So we need to learn the regex language, then we can work on it. I have explained it. So if you are liking the video, you can subscribe the channel. Keep enjoying and keep learning.